Hey, team. I know how we can hook failsafe up to the Nessus core and mine all the data we could ever want. Just help me place these beacons and I'll explain. These beacons should allow us to hook Failsafe into the Nessus core. Think of all the data she could pull.
It is a proactive and clever plan, friendly ghost.
I still think it's a bad idea.
This will work, trust me. You know how I usually hack and scan stuff for us?
I do.
This one's all you.
How fun.
Core is open. Get ready, Failsafe.
I am practicing my best Vex impressions. Please do not let them capture me, Captain.
Just treat it like tightrope walking. Don't think about it.
You're not helping.
You can do this, Failsafe. I believe in you.
If they kill me, I will haunt your shell. I have interfaced with the Nessus core.
See? Easy. Grab everything that's not nailed down.
The Vex are attempting to impede my progress. There should be a conflux nearby. Please stabilize it for me. Thank you, Captain. Now eliminate those data cubes. They contain security protocols that are blocking my progress.
You're a pro. I knew this could work.
The Vex are fighting back. I have marked other confluxes for stabilization. Destroy the cubes they generate.
Failsafe, the Vex have sent a mind after us. Failsafe, any updates? Okay, so she's been captured by the Vex. I'm so sorry. I can fix this. Get me the data core from that mind.
Thank you.
failsafe's gotta be in here somewhere. Help me get rid of the interference from these confluxes, and I should be able to lock onto her location. Got her. We've locked her in a cube construct. Take out the Vex and we'll free her. We hope it's not too late.
Captain, I have spent the last decade speaking with a fellow prisoner.
A decade? It didn't take us that long.
Time must work differently within the network. He was a very good listener. It's a shame I couldn't take him with me. He showed me a myriad of potentialities for this galaxy. How the Vex intend to shape them, I will share with your vanguard.
I'm so sorry I put you through that.
But you did. And I never forget those who wrong me. Attention all crew members. Incoming fallen craft with elevated ether signatures.
Accessing node 7874. I have prepared a ship's log for you, Captain. I know you did not request one, but I did not think that after all this time alone, I would ever have a chance to prepare another log. Log 163692. We are making positive progress in our daily endeavors. Active crew count, 3. Inactive crew count, 15. Inactive colonist count, 585. Quote of the day, hang in there, baby. End log.
All alone. Ugh. Humans.
What can I do for you? Aim well, my friend. Here we are. Did you wish to discuss something?
This forest again. Well, I can't say our last visit wasn't memorable. Let's see what we can find. Gotta love the ambiance. Hey, do you see that? Over there, the light.
You are a guardian of the last city. You are the hope for humanity. Some doctrines argue that the role of a Titan is to stand in defense of the city. The Strikers see a crackling offense as the best of defense. Strikers throw their bodies at incoming fire so others won't have to. It's also the most direct line to a target. Because you see, when a Striker turns her entire body into a projectile, no one is truly safe. And at close quarters, a fist is better than any gun. As a Titan, you lead the charge. You are the first into the fray. The body is made from tiny stuff, from near nothings. From atoms swimming through a blood of crackling sparks. Simple eternal laws shape the universe. The largest galaxy is ruled by principles of mass and motion. Electrons are slaves to charge and to chance. And this is why the universe feels inexhaustible, eternal. The light allows us to master charge and chance. Wielding arc energy in their fists, Strikers become the roar of thunder, the crash of lightning. Some of the greatest Titans have defined the charge. Lord Shex, Saint 14, Wei Ning.
When my ghost found me, when I was reborn as a Titan. She found me in a desert. I had died far from civilization, far from anything I could have possibly used to defend myself. I had the armor she made me, flimsy as it was, and 1,000 miles to walk to get to what she said was my new home. Of course, we ran into problems.
Heads up, fallen. I think these light projections might be lessons.
Bandits first, with guns scavenged from who knows where. My second death was terrifying. But I got back up, and the night sky sparkled overhead. And the man that killed me stared aghast. And I laughed. Immortal. Me. I could do anything. So I threw myself at him. If my body couldn't be broken, then that was my greatest weapon. Greater than any gun that could jam or knife that could dull. Each punch and charge and kick would only sharpen my skills. I taught the Strikers this truth. The fastest and surest way to a Guardian's victory is to rush headlong into that danger. Be unafraid. You are the lightning. And the thunder after it.
With Strikers at the fore, the Red Legion cannot hope to stand against us. We are the Titans of the Last City. We are Strikers, and we will not be stopped.
I hear the roar before I see him, but when I look up, I can make out a blue burst against the skyline. When he falls, he brings the sky with him. He scatters me and my squad to the wind, leaves us dead as the moment our ghosts found us. They bring us back, and he helps us up. Then he says one thing. He said, "Tell me what you've learned."
The shard of the Traveler, but we're not alone.
Hey.
Shard called us here. I'm sure of it. The Shard gave us a gift. Let's use it. Picking up fallen radio chatter. They're calling reinforcements. I think we aced it. I'm sure the Traveler called us to the forest deliberately. It's amazing that even a corrupted shard can still do so much good.
Thank you.